Hello everyone, and welcome back to W13 Universe. I'm your host, Jitch, and you are watching Friday Night SmackDown. We are just 5 weeks away from Capital Punishment, SmackDown's first ever solo-branded pay-per-view. Kicking things off here tonight, it looks like we've got ourselves another United States Championship Open Challenge. Can Drew McIntyre pull off defense number 7 of 8? McIntyre has proudly carried the United States Championship through the last 6 defenses. He has become more and more vicious, more and more determined with each successful defense. He has gone so far through Jack Swagger, Sheamus, Goldust, The Miz, Godfather, and Big Boss Man. Here tonight, who will be next up to step up and challenge Drew McIntyre for the United States Championship? This has been an incredible reign so far. Some absolutely magnificent defenses. Okay. Another newcomer. A lot of them accepting the challenge. I believe our general manager, Jerry Lawler, has a little bit something to do with this. That face shape may look a little familiar. That is the sun of SmackDown General Manager Jerry Lawler. That is his son Brian Christopher, aka Grandmaster Sexay, with his tag team partner Scotty Too Hotty. Tag team call themselves Too Cool, and they'll be a part of the SmackDown Tag Team Division. Well, I think this may have been, admittedly, this may have been Lawler pulling a few strings, a la McMahon with Shane McMahon over on Raw, but I have good faith that, Lawler is a more respectable gentleman. Sexy certainly knows how to make an entrance, but I don't know... Sorry, Sexay certainly knows how to make an entrance, but I don't necessarily think that means he's championship material just yet. Speaking of the tag team division, there'll be some follow-up to what happened with Chris Jericho last week. Apparently Jericho wasn't feeling 100% last week. Something was a little bit off. He thinks maybe there was something in his water. Chris Jericho has decided to sit out tonight's SmackDown for his own safety. But tonight, CM Punk will be going one-on-one with Edge. That will be our matchup next, as CM Punk continues to try and pick up momentum against the WWE Tag Team Champions. A rematch will be down the line, maybe at Capital Punishment, for Punk and Edge against the team. Sorry, for Punk and Jericho against the team of Edge and Christian. Grandmaster Sexay going very quickly into the offense. We're going to be finding out our main event for Capital Punishment tonight with an absolute blockbuster of a triple threat main event tonight. Triple H, The Rock, and Brock Lesnar all facing off against one another for a World Heavyweight Championship opportunity. The winner will meet The Undertaker for the World Heavyweight Championship, and as I said before, 5 weeks' time at Capital Punishment. I wish them all the best of luck in that matchup, although I gotta say, that is definitely some very fitting opposition for the Dead Man. You gotta think, if Drew McIntyre pulls off his US Championship defense tonight, then it will be fulfilled. He will have successfully done all 7 of his 8 defenses, and he'll only have a lot next week to contend with, is what I meant to say. I kind of really butchered that. Can the prophecy be fulfilled? Can Drew McIntyre truly be the greatest United States champion we've ever seen? We know that championship has been riddled with some very forgettable reigns. He wasn't wrong when he got rid of the championship and kind of spoke down to it. Some of the things he said about its history were very true. You know, the European Championship that he replaced it with so far has been a far more credible championship, currently held by Sheamus. That championship has only been held by 3 champions so far, from Drew McIntyre, who was injured and forced to relinquish it, to Wade Barrett, straight over to Sheamus. That has been lined with some brilliant champions, and Wade Barrett definitely will go down as the best so far. there are just tonight and next week if McIntyre can make it through Grandmaster Sexay tonight. And he will be successful in his pursuit of being the greatest U.S. champion. A big neck breaker takes down Sexay there. I gotta say, Drew McIntyre, he really had a hot streak to him. I mentioned this before, last week in his matchup with Big Boss Man, it seemed like something was really wearing on the patience of Drew McIntyre, or perhaps he was trying to contend with Sheamus, who defended his European Championship in similar vicious fashion, against Val Venus. Val Venus has demanded that he gets a do-over of his debut next week, not for the European Championship, not against Sheamus. He will handpick his opponent for next week, I've been told. So, get excited, SmackDown roster. Speaking of people trying to do do-overs on their debuts, tonight we've got the tag team debut of the New Age Outlaws, as we saw Road Dogg and Billy Gunn a couple weeks back on SmackDown. We saw Billy Gunn get bested and defeated by Goldust in singles competition. Here tonight they're going to be competing in tag team action against a new tag team here on SmackDown. I look forward to seeing the debut of that. Drew McIntyre perhaps looking to wrap this one up. Grandmaster Sexay is bleeding all over the place. Future Shock DDT. Is that defense number 7 right there? Scotty Too Hotty up on the apron. Scotty gonna try and watch his partner's back, and Sexay definitely capitalized at least a little bit there. I'm not sure how safe it is to be wrestling with those goggles on. So that seems like a safety hazard. It has created an opening for Sexay, though. He is now in control of the United States Champion McIntyre. Scotty and Sexay, you gotta be careful here when you're Drew McIntyre. Oh! McIntyre realizing Sexay trying to set something up for him on the outside, and I will forget that McIntyre's arm disappeared for a minute there as he takes Sexay back into the ring. With that big boot across the head, McIntyre going in for a cover again, and once again, Scotty Too Hotty distracting the referee as McIntyre goes in for a camel clutch-like submission hold here. Referee not even realizing that this is applied as Grandmaster Sexay very slowly works his way towards the ropes. And he got him, but the referee doesn't see. He's still distracted by Scotty. Scotty's not even doing anything. Flatliner drops Grandmaster Sexay center of the ring, and once again Scotty Too Hotty doing everything in his power to ensure that Sexay is able to get the victory here. And down goes Scotty, and Drew McIntyre Future Shock DDT. Is this going to be enough? He's got the cover. Referee still distracted, and Sexay continues to try and find a way out of this, but honestly, I think Scotty's just being a little bit cruel to his partner now. Sexay is hurt. He's worn out. Drew McIntyre trying to force a submission out of Sexay, perhaps. Referee's back is completely turned to the submission hold. Sexay has submitted. It looks like Drew has seen enough of this. Too cool. Really playing on the United States champion. And it looks like Drew McIntyre has had enough of Scotty Too Hotty at ringside. Controlling the waist. Missed him. Controlling the head. Oh, careful, careful. Oh my god! I think Grandmaster Sexay may have just about missed that. Big German suplex takes down Scotty Too Hotty. I guess Drew's realized if he can't win this match by pinfall, he's got to go for a countout perhaps, but Grandmaster Sexay is back up to his feet. And Drew realizes that, catches him with a devastating neckbreaker. Sexay is just so hot in this matchup. His partner Scotty really needs to let him just take the loss. Drew going in for some kind of butterfly-like move here, but Sexay was able to reverse it. Yeah, that's definitely been more competitive than your standard Drew McIntyre US Championship defense. For the wrong reasons, if you ask me. The skull-crushing finale? The hell? Shades of former WWE Champion The Miz. Top dog here on SmackDown not that long ago. And McIntyre would have kicked out very quickly from that. Oh, Sexay rolling him up. He's getting desperate now. This could be real trouble for the US Championship reign of Drew McIntyre. Big rope rebound boot across the face. And again, Scotty just won't get out of here. Referee has got to kick him from ringside. He is ruining this US Championship match. McIntyre taking a moment to hype himself up. Starting to feel bad for Sexay. That guy bleeding all over the place. Nothing out of the ordinary for a Drew McIntyre title defense just lately, though. McIntyre going in for the future shock. The butterfly light move again, my mistake. I thought it was the future shock. And again, Sexay able to reverse it. He's got that one clocked. And a second time, is this going to be enough? Is McIntyre's US Championship reign over? I can't believe it. Did Scotty's distractions pet? No. Drew McIntyre is hurt, though. You're starting to see the champion has actually been busted open. What a competitive US Championship match. I don't mean to discredit Sexay, but I definitely didn't have him clocked as the kind to put on this kind of competition for the championship. I knew he was a newcomer, but this just definitely took me by surprise. Drew actually having to get out of dodge from it there, give himself some space. Sexay just keeps fighting back. Finally, we've noticed that Scotty Too Hotty has been kicked from ringside. This has been an incredible debut for the son of SmackDown General Manager Jerry Lawler. Oh, careful, Drew. Oh, my God. This match might end in a count out. Grandmaster Sexay could be the first guy to really get the upset. Just can't believe how much of a goof this guy acts when he's in the ring. Drew got him with the neck breaker. He's tried this time and time again. And Drew, future shock DDT, US Championship on the line. Here's the cover. Is this gonna be enough? What a debut that was for Grandmaster Sexay. He may have lost that match, but I'll tell you what, I think he definitely will have won over some fans with that performance. That was incredible. Well, Drew McIntyre remains the United States champion another day, as he has got just one defense ahead of him. And you know, that's the thing, these defenses, they're starting to take their toll on Drew McIntyre. He's really starting to feel the effects of these defenses. Seven defenses deep, Drew McIntyre. No shame if he loses that championship next week. He has definitely, in my mind, proven that he is a brilliant United States champion as we move towards our next match of the night. Alicia Fox goes one-on-one with Nikki Bella, and both these two have been looking to impress just lately as they've been trying to turn their win-loss records around. Can tonight be the first night for Nikki Bella to pick up a victory? Believe it or not, just like Santina Marella over on ECW when all of her season two on Raw without ever picking up a victory, Nikki Bella did the same. In fact, Nikki Bella has never won a match. Can tonight be the night? I've got to say, a couple weeks ago when Nikki Bella faced off against Lita in Lita's debut match, I thought Nikki Bella was quite impressive, to be honest. It's not words I ever thought would leave my mouth, but she was quite impressive. She really showed something in her match with Lita. I think that Nikki Bella has definitely looked to improve quite a lot in the time of inactivity over on Raw. But you also can't blame Raw General Manager Miss McMahon for the way in which Nikki Bella was used. She hasn't exactly shown a lot of potential just yet, but that doesn't mean it's not there. That doesn't mean that Nikki Bella isn't a good competitor. I mean, we've seen recently Alicia Fox stepping up to the plate a little bit. She eliminated Karma in a Divas Championship match just about a month ago. We haven't actually seen Karma since. This is, I believe, the first match either... No, sorry, this is the first match Alicia Fox has taken part in this season. Brand new theme song. It's not very good, but it's... Yeah, I think I preferred her old one, I'll be honest. Coming up after this, we have got CM Punk going one-on-one with Edge. A long-awaited collision. I know these two have faced off in the past before, but... I feel like things are getting a little bit more heated between them, and I'm interested in seeing what happens when those two go toe-to-toe with each other in our next match of the night. Following that, we've got a tag team matchup, as I mentioned before. The New Age Outlaws set to compete against a brand new tag team here in SmackDown, and our main event contenders match for the World Heavyweight Championship, who will be facing The Undertaker at Capital Punishment. I cannot wait to find out. Three brilliant potential opponents for The Undertaker. Triple H, Brock Lesnar, and The Rock. You can't really go wrong with any of them. Undertaker, in recent weeks, has successfully defended that World Heavyweight Championship against both Jack Swagger and Rey Mysterio. And I definitely have to give a lot of credit to Rey Mysterio. As a man who has never competed for the World Championship before, to have gone toe-to-toe with The Undertaker the way he did last week, I think my perspective of Rey Mysterio has certainly been shifted. That is a man with a lot of potential. Great back and forth between Alicia Fox and Nikki Bella as these two look to one day become Divas Champion, a title that has been tightly held onto by Beth Phoenix. We'll pretend that she didn't have it inactive and send the entire Divas division over to join Raw's Women's division not that long ago. Beth Phoenix certainly doesn't seem to remember it. So she's been Divas Champion the entire time. Neither the base of Alicia Fox sends Shockwave up here. Back and forth these two go. Say, Nikki Bella really gave it her all against Lita, and I feel like she hasn't forgotten about her performance from a couple weeks ago. She hasn't forgotten about how close she came to finally picking up that first victory. And I think it's only motivated her more. Between Alicia Fox and Nikki Bella has been pretty impressive thus far. You gotta wonder if the Divas champion Beth Phoenix will be taking notice. Obviously, she'll have to defend that championship at Capital Punishment in just over 5 weeks. One of these two could be the challenger for Beth Phoenix's Divas championship. I don't think there's time for that right now, Nikki. Alicia Fox isn't that worn out. I think Drew McIntyre and Grandmaster Sexay certainly set the precedent for tonight's episode of SmackDown. That was a brilliant way to kick off tonight's show. U.S. Championship has become a very prestigious part of SmackDown. No doubt about it. The honor that has been put into that championship since Drew McIntyre was committed to bring it back has been off the charts. Nikki setting Alicia Fox up here. What's she gonna? Oh, Alicia Fox with the reversal, coming off the top with a big knee. Alicia Fox has picked up, I believe, 3 or 4 victories in her career, which is 3 or 4 more than Nikki Bella. You see, some say that Nikki's main inspiration is pure jealousy for how successful Brie Bella has been with Justin Gabriel. Obviously, that is not an in-ring competitor, but nonetheless, she has been impressive. Credit where due. Nikki Bella got Alicia Fox hung in the tree of woe there, but didn't seem to keep her down for very long. What is Nikki gonna do here? Well, he tried for something flashy, and that's what matters. yeah, that was a move. Here's a cover from Nikki Bella, and Alicia Fox quickly kicked out of that one. Look, his limb targeting on the ground too now. Hook to the eye by Nikki Bella. Very determined. Is this Bella? That wasn't very accurate. And Nikki Bella thinking she's got this one in the bag. She's going for something big here, clearly. Sizing up Alicia Fox, kick to the midsection, and plants the face of Alicia Fox flat on the mat, no ropes around. Is this going to be enough? And Nikki Bella picks up her first ever victory. Through grit and determination, the losing streak is finally over. Good showing between both of these women, but Nikki Bella, after a great performance against Lita a couple weeks ago, picks up the victory over Nikki Bella tonight. Wow, maybe things really will turn around for Nikki Bella on a different brand. It's only time will tell, but right now it's looking pretty promising as we move towards our next match of the night, CM Punk and Edge. This is a grudge match you don't want to miss. Upon coming here to SmackDown, CM Punk said no more tag team partners. From now on, he's only going to focus on him and building up his win-loss record. Unfortunately, an idea sparked in CM Punk's despite Edge, a former rival of CM Punk's, reigniting that rivalry as the two were tag team partners heading into the 2011 Elimination Chamber matchup. CM Punk requested that he face Edge and Christian in a non-title tag match that he had the perfect partner up his sleeve. That partner ended up being Chris Jericho, and what a great tag team these two ended up being as they defeated Edge and Christian in non-title action. But last week, I think something was a little bit off with Chris Jericho as he quickly submitted to a move locked in by Christian to lose the match. Chris Jericho says that he wasn't feeling himself, something was wrong, and he, for his own safety, decided to sit out tonight's SmackDown, leading to this one-on-one match here tonight. It's strongly believed there will be a rematch at Capital Punishment. Superstar! I'm so glad they put the way he says that in the game. That's brilliant. Well, there has been a deep investigation conducted across the footage from the SmackDown locker rooms on what may have occurred, what may have thrown Chris Jericho off his game. Nothing has been found thus far, but the investigation does continue on Jerry Lawler's behalf. Certainly hope that justice can be brought to whatever happened to Chris Jericho's edge. Strikes out the referee. That did not seem like an accident. The referee is out. Oh, hold up. Chris Jericho. CM Punk seems just as confused as we all do. I mean, Chris Jericho is off with an injury. Well, not injury, but for his own safety, he decided to sit out tonight's SmackDown. That's what we were told. And Jericho helping CM Punk up to his feet. Whoa! Hold up a second. What? Chris Jericho. Coming in to help his partner, I thought. What is this? I'm starting to think Chris Jericho may not have had anything wrong with him last week after all. But why? Why would Jericho do this? They don't have their tag entrance, in case anyone's curious. I didn't forget to set it up. It's not in the game. While the New Age Outlaws make their tag team debut here tonight, they say that what happened a couple weeks ago against Goldust, that was a fluke. That's not the way that it's going to go down for the New Age Outlaws, and here tonight they're going to prove that when they humiliate the newcomers that they are up against. Interested to see exactly who this tag team that they're going to be facing off against is. Okay, the Usos. Says it right there. Well, that was quite a strong reaction from the crowd on a debut. The Usos making their way here to the ring, and I believe this is what we call some hot free agents, as the fans have seen these guys in the past, I would imagine. Very anticipated debut here in the WWE as they make their first appearance here on SmackDown. Undoubtedly, future tag team champions. These two are a brilliant tag team. If you've not had the privilege of seeing them compete in unnameable companies before, I will tell you now, you're in for a treat. And they've changed their gear real quick, just so that they can high-five each other. Don't worry, they'll put that orange back on. They just had to quickly change to purple so they could high-five. You know how it is, you know, kids these days and all that. Right? Is that what's going to happen? I'm hoping that's what's going to happen. Hello? Maybe they just changed to purple. Maybe they just we're censoring it right now. They had to quickly go under the ring and change their gear. Yeah, that's what happened. Is that a twin magic or something? Any second now. There we go. See, they just had to put their gear back on. Well, I don't honestly know which Uso is which. I'll be clear with you. One of the Usos right now, starting things off with a House of Fire, very quickly laying waste to Road Dogg Jesse James. This is Road Dogg's in-ring debut. Last time we saw these two in action on SmackDown, it was Billy Gunn in a singles match against Goldust. I think it was Road Dogg against Goldust. My mistake. Billy Gunn was at ringside. This is Billy Gunn's debut. So you saw Road Dogg come out talking on the mic. That's right. Whereas Billy Gunn doesn't do that because he's an ass man. Wow. Oh my god, that is amazing! What an incredible move by Jimmy Uso. Someone in the crowd shouting out Jimmy, and like I now know that that's Jimmy Uso. I remember, I think Jay's got like a cross on his arm. That's how you tell them apart. Magneto, Jey Uso. I mean, they're literally identical twins, alright? It's really hard to tell sometimes. Yeah, I believe Jey Uso is on the cross on his arm. That's how, that's how I used to tell them apart. When I say used to, I mean, on the show I watched once. Road Dogg is getting absolutely creamed by these guys right now. I don't think the New Age Outlaws are all that right now. SmackDown Tag Division is stacked. Road Dogg trying to turn things around. Billy Gunn seems almost disoriented at the way that things have been kicked off here. And another one of those are amazing! I love that move. Just the throwing him up in the air, Samoan drop, and Road Dogg never stood a chance. These Usos came in just on fire, and they laid waste to the New Age Outlaws tonight. Oh, they have this as their victory too? That's kind of lame. That's right, guys, they were actually miming along. It was pre-recorded. I didn't really want to reveal that, but that's been revealed now. The Mum's a Whore, or whatever it is their song says. Oh, it's not going to play the rest? Of course it's not. Oh, there you go. The Usos are victorious as we move towards our main event. A triple threat matchup. The Rock, Brock Lesnar, and Triple H. One of these three men is lucky, if you want to call them that, enough to face The Undertaker for the World Heavyweight Championship at Capital Punishment in 5 weeks. I got told to get rid of the Disciples of Darkness and Tiny Shiny because the CAWs ruin it because they don't make it realistic enough. But apparently it's fine for me to still use Eddie Guerrero as an active wrestler or have a triple threat match on SmackDown between The Rock, Triple H, and Brock Lesnar. That's fine. No, it's the custom people that have got to go. It's got to be more realistic. Come on, guys. Everyone knows this is a more normal thing to see. But two newcomers establishing themselves over a lengthy period of time? Can't have that. Rock doesn't seem to be quite as in shape in this game. He had a very smooth tummy. Where was his abs? I bet Triple H has got abs. I also bet you in 2011 he fucking didn't have abs too. I bet he's fucking shredded as always. Oh wait, I don't know. That does look a bit more realistic. You know, he does still have muscle definition and pecs. But I don't see his super defined abs, to be fair. Yeah, it looks about right, actually. Wow. Well, Triple H and The Rock, this is what you call an absolutely star-studded main event. There is no better way to describe this level of matchup, but only the best of the best should get to face The Undertaker for the World Heavyweight Championship at Capital Punishment. I agree, I believe in that. And that's what we got. Some people argue that Brock Lesnar is due a World Heavyweight Championship rematch after losing the title to Batista back at WrestleMania 2, and he hasn't actually been given it. But Batista is no longer the champion, and therefore Brock Lesnar's rematch clause has expired, and he'll have to earn a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship. Believe it or not, since the draft back in April, this is actually Brock Lesnar's SmackDown debut here tonight. The superstar has not appeared once since being drafted. No one saw him or heard anything from him after he attacked Batista backstage. He was given a very hefty fine for that. Batista obviously going to be off for the next year. And Batista has been hoping that Brock will get his hands on that championship so he can take it right back off him again. Now, which could come true at Capital Punishment. But he's got to beat Triple H and The Rock tonight. And here he comes. Here comes the pain. He looks more like a human now. I like this. Brock is a fucking ogre in 12. I don't know what they did, but they made him like almost like too big. I know he was huge in like 2002/3 when he was around originally. But like, I almost feel like they overdid it. I don't know. It's really hard to explain. His proportions are just odd in 12. He looks like a human now. He looks like Brock Lesnar. I'm going to assume they maybe like weren't able to get him in for like a scan or something. So they kind of just had to make him off of like general knowledge and images and stuff. But then I don't know, because obviously they don't have like scans and stuff for like Mr. Perfect and like Eddie Guerrero and stuff, and they always end up looking fine. You know, Randy Savage in 12 looked perfectly fine. So I don't know, actually. Never mind that. Brock Lesnar, Triple H, and The Rock. One big triple threat matchup. First fall to the finish. Falls count anywhere. 20 minutes on the clock as of now. One of these guys has got to become the contender for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship, currently held by The Undertaker. I've been saying Capital Punishment is in 5 weeks. My mistake, it is 1 month from Sunday. We've got 4 weeks until Capital Punishment. SmackDown getting that first match booked nice and early, as obviously Raw will be presenting to you over the limit in 2 days' time. But don't watch that. I'm SmackDown commentator, don't watch that. Raw commentator says please watch that, but SmackDown commentator says don't watch that. SmackDown has got some of the biggest stars in the wrestling world in its World Heavyweight Championship division, and you gotta almost feel bad for superstars like Jack Swagger, who were such an important part of ECW on Tuesday nights as the ECW World Champion, but obviously he comes here to SmackDown and the game has changed. You know, I think he was a big fish in a small pond, and that's not to talk trash on ECW. But I think he was definitely a big fish in a small pond there. There wasn't a lot of competition coming his way. And those that did, people like Big Show and Kane, he always had the backing of McMahon to protect him. Whereas you look towards him here on SmackDown now, he's not got the backing and protection of McMahon. And he is definitely a small fish in a very, very big pond, because he is up against The Undertaker, Triple H, The Rock, Brock Lesnar, even, you know, Edge, CM Punk. These are all very experienced top guys. Sheamus, Drew McIntyre. SmackDown's got it all. I think Chris Jericho was doing pretty well for himself wherever he was the last year. He's back here now, so we don't talk about that anymore. It's really weird how accurate Triple H actually is in this game. Like, that looks like genuinely like Triple H. He doesn't look like this really weird, over-the-top built caricature of Triple H. I do wonder what will happen if this match goes to a timeout. Obviously, we had to give this a 20-minute runtime. We were only permitted to an hour and a half airtime here on the Sci-Fi Network, or whatever the fuck it was that SmackDown was on in 2011. Don't believe it was USA yet. Oh, no, I think it was, actually. Oh, I don't know. It's always just been on Sky Sports where I live, okay? They're always just Sky Sports. I don't have a lot more to go off of than that. Except now it's BT Sport. You know, we had one channel change, but all of it goes there as a whole. It's not separated. Triple H sending Brock Lesnar into the steel steps. Fascinated by the new gear of Brock Lesnar. Sorry. I remember this one comment I got where someone said I should play a UFC game and play a story mode as Brock Lesnar to kind of fill in the gaps for where he was when he was off injured in 12. And I think they said that right before I was planning on bringing him back. Because the plan was always he'd get taken out at Night of Champions and then he'd return at the end of the year and take the world title off of Sheamus for injuring him. That was the plan. You know, literally everything you've been seeing here, these have been my plans playing out. I've already gone over this like a billion times. And I remember getting this recommendation and I thought, hey, that's a pretty cool idea. But there was an issue with it, which was that I don't like UFC. So I wasn't ever going to buy the game and play it. But it was a really cool idea. I have a lot of respect for whoever came up with that. That was a brilliant little idea you had there. I'm just sorry I couldn't do it. I'm not interested in UFC, because obviously I could still do it now and just be like, oh, here's the story of where Brock was between like August and December or whatever it was. But I'm not a UFC fan. I don't like real sport. It's not as fun when it's real. What the hell is Brock doing? I've got to say, this has been a very physical fight between Triple H and The Rock, who have really almost dismissed Brock Lesnar from this whole match. Triple H is one of the best competitors and biggest troublemakers in the WWE. He's spending more time outside the ring than in it. Nicely avoided there. Triple H spent a very long time teaming up with Shawn Michaels here on SmackDown. Says that now it's time to realize his fullest potential as a WWE champion again. He of course means World Heavyweight Champion. He says that it's time for him to, release that full potential. Bring back the Triple H of old now that he is no longer associated with Shawn Michaels and D-Generation X. There's no need to focus on the tag team. It's all about Triple H going forward. Doesn't just hurt you, he'll taunt you, humiliate you. Brock Lesnar really doesn't like that boots to asses sign. He was trying to read it for a minute there. He didn't like what he saw. That's definitely why he was leaning over those ropes. He's like, the hell does that say? And then he started reading it. He's like, you son of a bitch. I got a feeling, Michael, that somebody's gonna get hurt and get hurt badly in this one. Big strike there by Brock Lesnar. Brock freaking Lesnar. I've got a feeling that soup's going to be on his diet. Brock freaking Lesnar. Triple H going in for a pedigree here on Lesnar as he drops the former World Heavyweight Champion, the only man in this match that has experience with the World Heavyweight title. The Rock has obsessively pursued World Championships. And the Miz has screwed him at every avenue, but the Miz is no longer an obstacle in the way of The Rock. I feel like 2011 could be a good year for The Rock. Big DDT busts The Rock wide open, but Brock and Rock both bleeding. No, sorry, Brock and Triple H both bleeding. I thought it was, Rock and Triple H. I thought it was Brock that was bleeding, but I don't think so. I'm not sure Triple H is either, to be honest. I'm just sure I saw someone other than The Rock get busted open. Take the fight outside, of course. Falls do count anywhere in this matchup. As I say, things have gotten very physical between Triple H and The Rock. There is clearly some bad blood brewing here between these two, I guess you could say, SmackDown veterans at this point. No, I guess it was just The Rock that was bleeding. I thought someone else was. Brock Lesnar crashing the party, dropping in, trying to steal a pin to get that World Heavyweight title shot against The Undertaker. Well, Undertaker and Brock Lesnar, that sounds like it could be a nightmare of a match. Triple H launched into the ring by Brock Lesnar. Both Brock and Rock holding their heads. Really some damage done there. Oh, I think Brock is bleeding, just not very much. Compared to The Rock, I guess. Well, I don't know, he's so pasty, you'd think he'd see it. I think maybe the game's just fucking up. I think he's supposed to be bleeding, and he's just not. Brock Lesnar. Oh, wow, just lifting him straight up for a second one. Okay, geez, Brock, enough! A third powerbomb on Triple H. Triple H jumping up to his feet. Bye. Oh my god, that was almost right on those steel steps, and that would have been something. Brock Lesnar measuring for an F5, but The Rock crashes it with a side suplex. And the Brock and Rock connection. Rock and Triple H fighting on the outside. Both these guys, I say, there is something brewing in this matchup. I've noticed that those two have been getting incredibly physical with each other. Almost dismissive of Brock Lesnar in this matchup. I thought I'd start holding my head just to join in with everyone in the match. Just put my hand on it. Okay, just a one count there. Triple H quick to kick out. Don't know how the referee even saw a kick out there. We're almost at the halfway point in the time limit of this match. I do wonder if this match ends in a time up. Does that mean all three of them face The Undertaker for the World Heavyweight Championship? We get ourselves a fatal four-way at Capital Punishment. Can't help but wonder these things. A lot of top dogs here in one match. I couldn't handpick who I'd want to see face The Undertaker out of these three. No idea who it could be. Big neck breaker by Triple H. Takes down Brock Lesnar. Rock lifting Lesnar up to his feet, but Lesnar quick to reverse there. Strikes down Triple H. The beast incarnate Brock Lesnar. Oh boy, locking in shades of his WrestleMania 2 opponent Batista. Locking in that stretch, but Triple H able to reverse it. Big leg sweep takes Triple H out. Brock Lesnar goes in for the cover. Is he going to be able to defeat Triple H? No. Roll-up attempt here by Brock Lesnar. Going for some desperation here, perhaps. Is this going to be an... Oh! Triple H actually felt the need to break that one up. That could have been it. Champion. 11 minutes down in this 20-minute match. Rock really starting to look in a bad state there. This is the first match The Rock has competed in a very long time. Took some time away after everything he dealt with The Miz, after the heartbreak he suffered at Elimination Chamber. Denied the WWE Championship once again, but The Rock could be back in contention tonight. All he's got to do is come out of this triple threat on top, but it's easier said than done. Triple H turning Brock Lesnar over, and this one continues to be a very back and forth triple threat. Oh no, not again. Okay, just the one that time. Rock strikes down Brock Lesnar. Both men in a very weary position. That was a good opportunity for The Rock there, but he decided to lift Lesnar up onto his feet. Maybe he just felt Lesnar wasn't quite done yet. I'm not sure we're going to see a winner, I'll be honest. Triple H striking away at the face of Brock Lesnar. He appeared to have reached a stalemate in this match, if you ask me. Triple H been busted open now. Brock Lesnar has got some kind of cut you can't see. Somewhere under his shorts, maybe like his thigh or something. Let's just go with that. There is definitely blood coming from him. Oh my god, okay. That was almost really bad for Triple H. Being crashed down onto that mat is one thing, but being crashed down with that much force onto a set of steel steps, I wouldn't wish that on anyone. See, we appear to have reached some kind of a standstill in this matchup. No one really able to get the upper hand on the other. Rock, ooh. Maitland drop. Seen a lot of those from the Usos earlier. That was a pretty great performance from Jimmy and Jay. Really great debut. Rock going in for a cover off of it. Is that going to be enough to get the job done? And oh, it was. I think Brock Lesnar was tending to whatever he had hurt there. He didn't realize that there was a pinfall happening. And The Rock is the number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship. He's done it. He'll be meeting The Undertaker at Capital Punishment.